Okay, so since I am taking a React course on Educative, I had to install Git Bash because that's my preferred terminal. I'd rather use that opposed to Command Prompt or PowerShell. And I also had to install Node and NPM. And I use NPM to install all the other dependencies that I need for JavaScript frameworks like Angular and React. So I'm about to install React and then I'm gonna head to the coffee shop. Although, yes, this is a plastic water bottle. I know. Get out of here. I know that some people like to go kick it. They like to go to the club on the weekend. But you know what? I like to program on the weekend. I'm kidding. However, on days like today where I really don't have anything to do and I've had a pretty busy last few weekends, so I kind of just want to relax, stay in the crib, and brush up on some programming skill sets. And special shout out to Educative for sponsoring this video. That first year, you're gonna learn a lot, like a lot. You're gonna be programming nearly every day for 8 hours. Okay, wait, you're not gonna be programming for 8 hours unless you hate people, but you'll probably program like 5 to 6 hours a day, and you'll have meetings, you'll have lunch, and let's be honest, is anyone productive 8 hours a day for how many days you work a year? No. But you're gonna learn a lot. The first thing you need to do is you wanna get a group of friends who are experiencing a similar situation as you. And no, I don't mean friends on Call of Duty or RuneScape, but actual people who you can interact with every day and are entry-level software developers out of college, entry-level technical consultants, or just friends who are starting their careers out of college just like you. So luckily, right out of college, at the company I started working at, they take training really seriously, and at the time it was annoying and I didn't want to do it. I just wanted to go to my desk and I wanted to start building enterprise web applications and solutions. But now that I'm looking back at it, I'm really glad I had that training opportunity. And the reason being is because I was able to train with people that I interned with. I was able to train with other people that I didn't know, but were also recent college grads. Like literally graduated like a month or two before they started this job and even graduated from the same school as me. So we all were able to become good friends and have that bond and also try to figure out what the heck adulting is together and how to navigate our careers. Had I went straight to my desk, I definitely wouldn't have had the same experience that I had with building relationships with other people right out of college. I would have gotten more programming under my belt, but it's deeper than that. When you're working at a job 8 hours a day for 5 days a week, if not more hours than eight, you're gonna wanna build relationships with people because they're gonna be like your family. They're gonna be one of the reasons why you're always happy to go into work. Despite the work you're doing, even if you don't like the work you're doing, you're gonna have a smile on your face because you're like, oh, I'm gonna have lunch with such and such. We're gonna go to happy hour together. We work together and you'll enjoy it. For your first 6 months, I know you're a young whippersnapper who's excited to program and thinks you can go 12 hours a day on just Red Bull, Coca-Cola, and Twizzlers. But in reality, unless you're at a company that needs you to start doing production programming right away, you're gonna be spending a lot of time training because your manager wants to make sure that you can catch up on the latest framework and learn the programming language that you're gonna be programming in. So take advantage of that extra time and utilize sites like Educative, who just so happen to be a sponsor of this video. Educative is an interactive, mobile-friendly in-browser experience featuring executable code playgrounds in multiple programming languages, so you can try to solve problems in-browser without the need to set up your own environments. I like that you can take quizzes after a section of the course, which reinforces the material you've learned. User experience is great and makes learning fun, not stressful, and not difficult, although some of the topics covered
are difficult to learn.
What I especially appreciate about this e-learning platform is that it is dedicated to software developers like myself. I feel confident that I can level up my coding skills quickly and efficiently. Educative also understands that sometimes you need more than one course to achieve your learning goals. So there are multiple learning tracks that arrange courses on a topic in a sequence, which will save you the effort of going through their courses, finding out which ones fit together and what order they fit together. So if you want to become a machine learning engineer, you can become a machine learning engineer. If you are a full stack developer and you want to become a front end developer like myself, they have a front end development course. And if you're also interested in other programming languages like React, Python, Java, and C++, there are tracks out there for you. If you are trying to broaden your skill sets, you can try a few lessons as a free preview before purchasing. Educative is giving a coupon code for 10% off to the first 50 users if you select the link below or you go to educative.io/Jossie and 10% will be automatically applied to your order. My first 6 months, I was like, what the heck's going on? I have no clue what's going on. Do you know what's going on? Does anyone know what's going on? But then I got integrated into a team and I started taking initiative on learning a new platform. And at that time it was Angular. So I didn't have any pull requests to do or anything like that. This is like the first 3 months. This is like after training, but I started mocking things up using Angular. So not like mocking things up with like a graphic design tool, but actually like building a static web app using Angular. And by doing that, that showed people at my company that, hey, Jossie's interested in modernization. Jossie's interested in Angular and web applications. And that helped me a lot because basically when my team got reorganized, they put me on a team that was gonna modernize their product. And they felt confident that I'd be able to do that because of something that I built and demoed a few months back. And then after that, you know, I wanted to get my first pull request out because I'm like, oh my goodness, I haven't gotten a pull request out. I haven't done any production programming. I just felt like that I wasn't like, I don't know, like, you know how sometimes you just want to get something done so you can show your worth? That's basically what I was trying to do. So then I got my first pull request out. After your first 6 months, I promise you'll be more confident in your ability as a software developer. You've built relationships with your Scrum team, managers, and hopefully others outside of your team and even department. So now you come to work upbeat and joyful for not just the coding, but for the people. Of course, expectations have increased and so has responsibility, but don't let that scare you. Now that you've built a new feature or two, you're comfortable in the code base. And at this time, you want to figure out which part of the stack you enjoy the most. That way, when it's time to select stories to complete, you know exactly what you're good at and can complete within the sprint. Thanks everyone for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you liked it at all. Share it with someone who you think might benefit from it. And if you haven't already, hit that subscribe button and notification bell, all that good stuff. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram to get more of a behind the scenes of kind of my life and how I make some of these videos. As always, have a blessed week. And once again, shout out to Educative for sponsoring this video.